back watching TV at 10 p.m. in Australia is pretty tame. You might get a little peek at some tits and ass and the occasional gory explosion, but every night on South American networks and a growing number of TV outlets around the world, you get this.
Bloody murder, gruesome rape, big budget violence, and drugs. Copious amounts of drugs.
Welcome to the world of Narco Novellas.
Soap operas depicting the dark, uncensored reality of the drug war across South America. The bulk of them produced in Colombia.
I was in the city of the middle of the city, and suddenly a car exploded with I don't know 500, I don't know how many kilos of dynamite.
Alex, a Colombian narco novella actor currently living in Sydney, played the lead role of a vicious hitman in one of the first narco soaps ever made. It was one of his most memorable gigs, but not a story he enjoyed telling as a Colombian.
The drug cartels changed our society. Some of our friends or a friend of a friend was killed. Everybody in Colombia felt that sadness, that crazy thing in Colombia.
Most of the storylines are based on real-life scenarios around the rise and fall of Colombia's drugs cartels in the 90s. In almost all of the novellas, you'll see tales of the seedy drug underworld, starring silicon-filled, coked-up drama queens and drug kingpins with looks that could kill. And they do. There's so much death. All wrapped up in ridiculously high production value.
And record-breaking audiences right across the Spanish-speaking world can't get enough of it.
The Cartel of the Snitches reels in a whopping 9 million local viewers every night. Without Tits, There's No Paradise and El Capo both clock in almost 2 million. The Queen of the South has more than 4 million eyeballs glued to Spanish TV screens every night. Now, Colombian networks are selling their shows worldwide, and everyone wants a piece of the action. Today, the soaps are being broadcast in more than 41 countries, and they're killing it in America. In its premiere week, La Reina del Sur, or Queen of the South, ranked number one in the 10 p.m. time slot right across US networks. It was also the first to feature a female drug lord. The popularity of narco soaps has even nabbed the attention of the Pentagon. They're commissioning their own novella in an attempt to quash the drug war in other parts of Latin America.
La respuesta de los televidentes es que ha pasado muy, 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 muy chévere. Me llegan mensajes de todos los países. La gente preguntándome si el capo 3, personas que en Twitter, en Facebook, se llaman capo adictos.
Lilo Villaplana is the director of El Capo. We spoke to him while on set filming the current series in Bogotá.
Y para el público, que el público entienda este fenómeno.
But what's become a multi-million dollar industry and one of Colombia's best-selling cultural exports has sparked equal amounts of controversy. Narco soaps have copped backlash from the international press, prompted public protests, and fired up Latin America's politicians, police, and feminists. Subsequently, all networks were forced to broadcast narco novellas after 10 p.m. Initially, they were screened in primetime slots.
Y en el caso de las novelas colombianas que tocan el tema del narcotráfico, me parece muy interesante que se toque, porque para no repetir las cosas malas en la historia hay que contarlas hasta el cansancio.
Critics argue the novellas glamorize the violence-obsessed lifestyles of drug cartels. They're misogynistic and they promote vicious crime. But defenders of the genre say they serve as cautionary tales because just as in real life, the show's kingpins always end up in jail or dead.
Pablo Escobar, the boss of evil, had more than 11 million viewers on its opening night, a record for Colombian television. It tells the story of Colombia's most notorious villain, almost two decades after he was gunned down. Escobar was known as the bloody and lavish drug lord who swamped the world with cocaine and is linked to at least 5,000 murders. Two of the show's creators know Escobar's violence firsthand. Juana Uribe wrote and produced the series. Her mother was kidnapped by Escobar. Her uncle was murdered by Escobar's cartel. Camilo Cano, co-producer on the same show, was 20 when Escobar's henchmen killed his father. Up until recently, most Colombians were too afraid to talk because they feared for their lives.
Durante mucho tiempo no se hablaba del tema, creo que fue una como una limitación, una autocensura que se puso en muchos creadores y había cierto miedo a tocar el tema.
Most of them are dead, or the rest are in jail in America or even in Colombia, no? So it's easier to talk about that people in that moment.
Colombia has come a long way in shaking off its dark past. The homicide rate in Colombia has dropped 50% in the past decade. But drug-fueled violence has just moved next door to Mexico, now reportedly the most dangerous cocaine-fueled region on the planet. Despite the backlash, Narco Novellas fit the perfect TV mold for compelling viewing. The world over, it seems we're obsessed with underworld crime, hardcore action, sex and gore on our screens. And the show's producers know it all too well. They're racking up big dollars. So the business of narco soaps, it's probably just going to get bigger. More shows, more countries broadcasting them. Maybe even dubbed into English right here in Australia.